things from the rizq, from the provision of Allah. And likewise, will be tarki zina and abandoning the adornment of the beautiful clothes or the beautiful or the nice garment and the like. And for that, they used to abandon certain type of animal, from the Baha'imul An'am, min ajli asnamihim, because of their idols, And likewise, as the Shaykh Hafidhahullah mentioned, that you find from the mutasawwifa, that likewise those among us that abandon the good from the yani la ya'kuluna min at-tayyibat, they will not be eating from the pure and lawful things, good things, and they will be alaykum salam, they will be any deficient in regard to any the dress code and the like. And yaz'umuna anna hadha ibadatan lillah, and thinking that abandoning the pure and lawful things, it was an act of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah jalla wa ala, he refuted them. Qul say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man harrama zinat Allah, who is the one that made haram the beautiful things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allati akhraja li'ibadihi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put forth for his servants, wa tayyibat, and the lawful things, pure and lawful things, mean a risk from the provision. And likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tuharrimu tayyibati ma ahallallahu lakum, O you who believe, do not make the pure and the lawful things, do not make it haram, that Allah after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it halal. So therefore, that this that you find from the people, yani abandoning that which is the tayyibat, from the risk, from the provision of Allah, as a mean of seeking nearness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever does so, that the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, as he mentioned, that he is this individual has from yani created a lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, but rather, in conclusion, Shaykh Fawzan, he mentioned that inna Allah, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inna Allah jameelun yuhibbul jamal, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful, and he liked that which is beautiful. And likewise, in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, inna Allah yuhibbu إذا أنعم على عبده إذا أنعم على عبد نعمة أن يرى أثر نعمته عليه. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned إن حديث أخرجه إمام الترمذي رحمه الله وقال حديث حسن. He mentioned that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves to see when he bless his servant. He loved to see yani the athar, the effect, or the trace of that which he has blessed, yani to be shown in his servant that which he has blessed him with. And this was barakallahu fikum the two mas'ala that we had dealt with, which was 72 and 73. Amma al mas'ala al rabi'atu wa sab'un, the aspect number 74, which is a very important mas'ala barakallahu fikum. دعوتهم الناس إلى الضلالة. The people of Jahiliyyah, they used to call the people to what? To misguidance. They used to call them to misguidance. دعوتهم الناس إلى الضلال بغير علم. بغير علم. Now this is an important point here. And the only difference, barakallahu fikum, with the masala number 75 is this word right here. دعوتهم الناس إلى الضلال بغير علم. The word بغير علم. The word بغير علم. So you, those who have the book, underline the word بغير علم. Calling the people to misguidance without knowledge. Calling the people to misguidance without knowledge. شيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله ورعاه وأيله ونصره، يسي الدعوة إلى الله بغير علم هي من عمل أهل الجاهلية. Calling to Allah without no knowledge base, it is indeed from the trails and the ways of the people of Jahiliyyah. Calling to Allah without no knowledge, it is the what? The trail of the people of Jahiliyyah. Where are the tablighis? Huh? Allahu Akbar. You go into, you say you're calling to Allah, and this individual just yani left being drunk. He's still, barakallahu fikum, trying to find his soberness or the like. And you're going to tell him, go ahead, tell us about la ilaha illallah. And this guy, he's trying to be on his feet. He's trying to not to stumble down because he's still high. He's still drunk. But you tell him, go ahead, tell us about la ilaha illallah. الدعوة إلى الله بغير علم هي من عمل أهل الجاهلية. Calling to Allah without no knowledge, it is from the actions of the people of Jahiliyyah. You say, لأن الله, because Allah indeed أمر بالدعوة إلى سبيله على بصيرة وبالحكمة وموعظة الحسنة والجدال بالتي هي أحسن. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commanded what? بِالدَّعْوَى إِلَى سَبِيلِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, order us to call to His way, to call to His way, but عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ, upon crystal clear knowledge, وَبِالْحِكْمَةِ, and upon wisdom, وَمَوْعِذَةُ الْحَسَنَةِ, and upon giving a good admonishment, وَالْجِدَالِ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ, and in the argumentation that is the best ways. So therefore, فَدَعْوَتُهُمُ النَّاسِ إِلَى الضَّلَالَةِ, أي تَرْغِيبِ النَّاسِ فِي مُخَالَفَةِ الْحَقِّ. They're calling the people to misguidance. It is that they are inciting the people to be in opposition of the truth. Subhanallah al-Azim. Inciting the people, motivating the people to be in opposition of the truth. Now this individual that is calling you to the falsehood, they have no knowledge. But he is inciting you, calling you, motivating you, right? Pushing you, pumping you up to do what? Mukhalafa anil haq, to oppose the truth. He doesn't have no knowledge of the detail, but he doesn't want you to be upon the truth, upon the haq. He's calling you to be up away from the truth. So he mentioned, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّبِعُوا سَبِيلَنَا وَلْنَحْمِلْ خَطَايَاكُمْ. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, and the disbelievers, they say to the believers, follow our ways, اتَّبِعُوا سَبِيلَنَا, follow our ways, وَلْنَحْمِلْ خَطَايَاكُمْ, and we'll bear your sins, we'll be responsible for your sins. Follow our ways, and we'll be responsible. We'll bear your sins. خطاياكم. Surah Al-Ankabut, verse number 12. فَيَدْعُونَهُمْ إِلَى الشِّرْكِ. So they are calling them to polytheism. وَإِلَى تَحْرِيفِ الْحَلَالِ وَتَحْلِيلِ الْحَرَامِ بِغَيْرِ حُجَّةِ. And they are calling them to تَحْرِيمِ الْحَلَالِ, to make the halal haram. And they're calling them to tahleel al-haram, to make that which is haram to be halal, without any hujjah, alaykum salam, without any evidence. This is that which they're calling them to. He said, وَيَدْعُونَهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَشْيَاءَ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِن سُلْطَانٍ. And they are calling them to things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never set forth no authority in those. They're calling them to matters that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never legislated. فَهَٰؤُلَاءِ دُعَاتُ الضَّلَالَةِ These are the callers of falsehood. These are the callers of misguidance. These are the callers of evil. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ And if you all remember, in Usul al-Sunnah by Imam Ahmad with the Shara of Sheikh Fawzan, and Sheikh Fawzan hafizahullah was dealing with the issue of the appearance of the Dajjal. He brought the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he mentioned غَيْرُ الدَّجَّالِ أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ He say, other than the Dajjal, I fear for you. Allahu Akbar. He say, غَيْرُ الدَّجَّالِ أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ He say, other than the Dajjal, I fear for you. And which was who? The ulama usu, the callers of misguidance. In Sharabi Hafidah, he say, لِأَنَّ الدَّجَّالِ مَكْتُوبٌ لَدَيْهِ Because الدَّجَّال, it is written on him, كَافْ فَرَى He say, the believers, they will be able to read it. سَوَاءٌ they know how to read or not how to read, they will be able to read it. But أَمَّا the دُعَاءُ الضَّلَالَةِ They will be wearing the cloak that we wear. They will be speaking the language we speak. They could be even, barakallah, if you come quoting the ulama we quote. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. And as you all remember, barakallah, فيكم نستيم الشيخ فوضان حفظه الله. When he mentioned, الداعي الذي لا يخذر من دعاة الضلال من دعاة الضلالة he say يعتبر من من الكاتمين العلم من الكاتمين العلم he said that the caller that does not warn against the misguidance and the people of misguidance he say he is to be considered as one of those who are hiding knowledge as one of those who are hiding knowledge as those who are hiding knowledge so you will be amazed barakallahu fikum by people only having a position of clarifying matters to the people but they will not even not go to the general matters they will just touch up the surface right embellish it make it like you know nobody gonna have no position against them.
What if the individual, you know, people may say, you know, he does warn, he says the word Sufi, he says the word Tablighi.
Okay, those are the generalities. Because believe me, if you say that the Sufi, the Tijani man, no, you talking to him. Straight up. You're talking about the Tijani, right? If you say the Sufi, the Tijani will not think that you are addressing him. Are you addressing his belief? Are you talking about Barakallahu Fikum, the Naqshbandi? He will not think that you're talking to him. You're talking about a sect that existed, yani intaha, that is finished. But rather, La Buddha Barakallahu Fikum, that these matters to be raised, to be clarified, Barakallahu Fikum, in our classes, on the minbar. And likewise, Barakallahu Fikum, openly, hatta the people will know. Those who are barakallah in opposition of what? In opposition of the sunnah. In opposition of the sunnah. If you have a masjid that is maybe five blocks away from Masjid Tawheed, that is a masjid, that is a Sufi masjid. I mean literally, whatever you find in the masjid bisect, that's the same principle that you will find in there. Same thing. Though alhamdulillah, it is a must for these masajid, the likes of them, to be barakallahu fikum warned against so hatta the people will not barakallahu fikum not take knowledge and not frequent them and know that they are upon misguidance now the people say well they say la ilaha illallah akhi say la ilaha illallah la yakfi they say muhammad rasulullah say muhammad rasulullah la yakfi akhi the first point that imam ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala brought in usul sunnah was what بما كان أصحاب رسول الله look he didn't say the first principle is that we hold on to the Quran and Sunnah He didn't say that.